In this video, I will show you how to set up a rollup calculation. A rollup is a way to easily calculate summary statistics for your assets. Let me show you what a rollup looks like. I'm here in PI System Explorer, and I'm looking at the AF database for discrete manufacturing. Now, rollups were used to determine these two KPIs: the average number of bad units produced by each line at a plant facility for the week. And notice the plant facility that we're taking a look at is Cleveland, and Cleveland happens to have 5 different lines. And the other KPI, the total number of good units produced by all the total lines at the facility for the week. Well, where did the information for this calculation come from? It actually came from the child attributes. If we look at the different lines, we can see that they all have these count bad and count good attributes right here. And these attributes are used for the average and total taken at this level. And this has been done for each facility, so Cleveland, Detroit, Houston, etc. These KPIs can be easily compared. Now, for an element, a rollup is set up under the Analyses tab. If you don't see this Analyses tab in PI System Explorer, you probably aren't using the latest version of the PI server, which includes AF Server 2014, or the client tool. I could set up these two rollups for each of the facilities, but to save even more steps, I'm going to do the rollup at a template level. And I can do this because each of these facilities and the other ones are based off of a plant facility template, which you can find under Library and Templates, Element Templates, and then the Facility template is right here. The rollups were set up under the Analysis Templates for that facility template. I'm going to step back and show you all the steps to set up these two rollups. If you're setting up a rollup on an element, you would use the Analyses tab that we looked at before and perform the same steps. Let's start from the beginning. So I'll start off by choosing the Create a New Analysis. And now the Analysis Templates panel looks similar to how we saw before. We start off on the right-hand side. I'm going to give this rollup a name of Average Bad Units. And I'll include a full description. And for organizational purposes, I'll also choose the KPI category. You can create your own categories as a way to organize your analyses and improve the ability to search for them. The next important selection is choosing rollup, this middle option here. One thing to keep in mind when working off a template is you'll need to select an example element. This is because the template itself does not have attributes that are linked to specific values to evaluate a calculation from. So Detroit is one of the example elements, but if I click on Detroit, I have basically the option of choosing any example element that is based on the facility template. Then I'll need to choose where to get the rollup attributes from. As we saw earlier, there are child elements of each line which contains the attributes that we're interested in. So I'll stick with the child elements option. Next, I will need to find the attributes that I want to roll up by using this search criteria. I'll choose the attribute name since I know that there's a count bad attribute. And as I type that in, this entire attribute list showing up on the right, which is based off of the attributes of all the child elements of Detroit, now have check marks next to the attributes that match the criteria. These count bad. Then I'll choose the function. In my case, the function that I'm interested in is this average here. I can use the evaluate button to look at what the result of that calculation would be at this particular moment. I'll additionally need to choose where I would like this calculation to be output to, and I'll select Map. Once I select Map, it will bring up a list that includes all the attributes that are available in this template. And I've already set up an average bad units attribute before. Later on, we're going to see how to create a new attribute template and explore the options of writing to Py tags in addition. For now, I'm going to select my average bad units attribute, and the last choice that I'll need to make is on the scheduling, down here. For the average bad units, I want to have this calculation run anytime one of these count bad attributes gets a new value. So I'm going to choose the event triggered option, and it will trigger on any input. Now that I've done all the configuration for the rollup, I'm going to check in my changes. Navigating back to my elements, I see that I have the average bad units. Right now my value is 0, which is simply what the default value was for my template. But I happen to know that the values for the attributes the rollup is based off of update pretty frequently, so I'm going to go ahead and hit refresh. And it looks like I have received a new value, so my average bad units now has a value for the rollup calculation. So this is what the average bad units rollup looks like for my different facilities. Let's go back and set up, under the analysis template, the other rollup that we saw. To create a second analysis, an easy way to do that is to right-click on this white space and select New. I'll again go to the right and start with the name. This will be the total good units. And again, I'm choosing the rollup option. I'm still interested in the attributes of the child elements, and I'll use the attribute name to look for count good. And in this case, I'll choose to do a sum, and I'm going to map this. Before, we talked about that you don't have to map it to an existing attribute, so I'm going to use the new attribute option, and then I'll be able to choose its properties. To keep things nice and organized, I'll choose the KPI category, and it's always good to set a unit of measure to keep track of things. And this will be a count. And I could choose a value type of double, but I'll actually switch to single. And for the data reference, I'm going to leave it as a Py point and hit the settings. One of the exciting new options is the ability to write the analysis outputs to Py tags and to have those tags created through AF, using this tag creation selection option. It is actually highly recommended to store the analysis to Py tags so that you can historize the data, and it also improves the AF performance. The tag attributes can be figured by selecting this dropdown. I'm going to use the defaults and hit OK. Lastly, I'll schedule it, and in this case, the total good units, I'm interested in evaluating this at the end of a shift, is I'll use the periodic scheduling. In this case, I could go ahead and say if I had shifts every 8 hours that I wanted to run this calculation for, I could go ahead and set it up this way. And this provides at the bottom the example evaluation times. Your shifts were every 8 hours but didn't start at midnight, then you could use this specify offset. Now, for the purpose of this video, I'm actually going to reduce my shift time considerably so we could see this actually being evaluated right away. I'll go and check in my changes. And now if I navigate to elements, you'll notice that I have both of my rollups, and there's this interesting message on Py point not found. Now, I thought we had checked that box for tag creation. Well, that enables the tag creation, but in order to create the tags, what I'll need to do is actually If I want to do this for all of them at the same time, I'll right-click on Elements, and I'll choose the Create or Update Data Reference. This will create or update those tags. I'll check in my changes. And now I have the average bad units and total good units for each.